Chris Inhabitants of the Town of Sutton. In accordance with the provisions of Mass General Law, Chapter 48, Section 11, the Zoning Board of Appeals will hold a public hearing at the Sutton Town Hall on March 8th, 2018, at 7:30 p.m. on the petition of Joseph Sherrell. The petitioner requests a special permit as it pertains to Section 1C2D of the town zoning bylaws to construct a garage addition with living space above. The property that is the subject of this petition is located at 37 Maple Lane, as shown on Assessor's Map Number 15, Parcel Number 36. The property is located in the Residential Rural Zoning District. A copy of the petition may be inspected during normal office hours in the town's clerk's office located in the town hall. Any person interested or wishing to be heard on this variance petition should appear at the time and place designated. Daniel Petrelli, Board of Appeals Clerk. Welcome, if you could state your name for the record.
Jamie Magrupis, representing Joe Shirelli, potentially the contractor.
Jamie, could you just move that forward? It's wireless, so I guess you're not responsible. So we can hear you.
Hello? I put together an elevation, kind of give you an idea what it is.
Good.
Looking at the point of old drawings, because we don't know if we're doing it or not. So I'm going to hand this to you guys, if you can hand them down.
Everybody get one? Lynn, do you need one?
So the 16 feet that we're looking for, out of that 16 feet, there is presently a deck that's positioned taking up roughly about 10 feet of that 16 feet. So we're looking for really an additional 6 feet for the addition.
Is that represented by sort of the line in the middle of the rectangle here?
Yes. Yes and no.
Like, not quite, right?
It's roughly about 8 feet of depth, but then okay. The landing that goes down, it chews up another 3 to 4 feet.
I have a photo that I was looking at a map, and somehow a photo of the house came up. I think it's the same photo from Google Maps or something like that, but it shows the deck on it. Look closely.
Okay.
The deck's not going back on?
Deck is not going back on. Once they figure out the layout and how it's going to work, they may be looking for a set of stairs going out the back and then wrapping down the back side of the house just to get egress from that additional space. But it would not encroach upon that side setback any more than the 16 feet that we're actually proposing in the plot plan.
Okay.
The opposite side of the house, that's all septic over there, so the possibilities of landing that on that side of the house, the tank is about 10 feet from the house, so it really isn't an opportunity. But the way the house lays out with the garage, one of the garages already being to the right side, it only makes sense that that garage be there also.
Okay. And obviously you're just matching all the roof lines and all that according to your sketch?
We haven't completely finished the design or even started the design, but the preliminaries were that the roof lines, it would not extend any higher than the existing roof line. It may step down a little bit, you know, maybe 6 inches to a foot to tie these things together.
Okay.
But once again, it would not be any higher than the existing roof line.
Okay. Any questions from the board?
There's one existing garage space right there.
Where that vehicle is. That is a garage underneath. Correct.
Okay.
Jimmy, are you going to use the existing driveway and widen that at the base, or are you going to widen it all the way at the mouth, all the way to the road?
I would assume it's either. I don't know that answer. I don't believe it needs to be widened at the road. If it just flares out as it comes in to get you into the other garage, that's probably all he's looking for.
Okay.
That, so rear, the back of the house, you know, 50 feet's the setback, you talked about deck stairs, you're not showing any of that, you, so you'd be in the setbacks too, if you, so if you do anything, I believe, in addition to what you drew. Cause front's 50, back's 50, and side's 20. So if you're not showing a porch, that you need a porch?
It wouldn't be a porch, you'd come out to a 3-foot landing and just set a stairs down, is what we'd be proposing.
But I think that's part of lot coverage and setbacks, and I believe that all falls under the same as the addition.
But he's going for the special permit, so, there shouldn't be an issue as long as the board finds that there's no issue.
So when are you gonna know?
So under a special permit, what we've been doing is the plans are what we usually approve, and then that's what you get to build.
Okay.
So if you don't show a deck or a stair, especially where it's in the setback, so that's something we need to weigh in on, because that's part of the, what you're asking to do on the special permit is be in the setbacks and you're not showing it all. So even if you wanna draw it in, I'm fine with drawing it in, but I would at least show the footprint of what you're trying to do.
Okay.
We typically even would like to see elevate, you know, full elevations, not drawings for a building permit, but at least front, rear elevations and a floor plan.
Yeah.
And we make that part of the approval.
Yeah, the architectural plan.
I think the thing that's most important is that the footprint's correct.
Okay.
That if you guys aren't sure what you want, you should firm that up between maybe now and the next meeting, if you don't know what they want.
Okay.
I'm just, I would feel more comfortable if it just depicted what you wanted to do.
And once again, doesn't have to be a full-blown architectural.
I was fine with your hand drawing it in, but, you know, keep it simple, if it, just as long as your plot plan reflects what you wanna do when you go to get your building permit. And Jamie, it's not, it's just that when you're, you know, like, it's just to be consistent, and we.
Because this sketch, even if we put the, if we drew the stairs on with some new measurements, rough.
Yeah, like I said, even if you drew, if you knew right now that.
We can write into our approval that we want the roof lines to match or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Not that they're trying to go three stories, but we just wanna be sure what we have in front of us.
Sometimes you give somebody an inch, they take a mile, so. We've had problems, so what we do is we just like the plot plan to be right. It gives John and everybody, when you go and do the project, and you say, oh, well, no, they told me I could do this, and we say, no, that's not the intent of what we.
Completely understood.
Yeah, that's all, just.
We'll reference this drawing too, so that if anything does come up, we can say, well, no, this is what he showed us, and this is what we based our approval on, not.
So the goal was just to get, be able to get out a slider, onto a landing and down. He may put a grill on there, so now that doesn't extend, call it 4 feet. You got your grill there, he's out and he's down. I understand what you're saying.
I'd put bigger than you want then if you're not sure.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think, you know, all I'm saying is just cover yourself so that the footprint of what we approve, just nothing gets questioned when you go to build it.
Okay, so if we can extend off of that 16 by 24, an additional 6 feet of landing.
If you just want to draw it on one of them.
Down to a set of stairs, just to get them down to grade.
I think what you should is just show, like, just draw it on there, yeah.
Some stairs, anything else?
Oh, sure. Yeah,
potential coverage for whatever.
Sounds perfect to me. That was my only comment. Just
yep. Okay.
If he was gonna have a deck, let's just show it on the plan.
Any other questions from the board members? Is there anyone here who would like to speak for or against this application? Come on up. Just state your name.
Gary Burrell. 42 Maple Lane, 4753 LLC. So I'm just here to speak for Joe Shirelli. I mean, in favor of it, not for him, but spoke to him on the phone today. But he's a good neighbor, and I like the plan he's thinking of. He's really just trying to make the deck living space, put another garage under it, and, you know, that's it. Just make the house more functional. I know he's consulted with all the neighbors down at next driveway, so.
In-law, you said, right, Jamie?
Excuse me?
In-law? In-law apartment above the grill?
No.
Oh, you can't, I mean, it doesn't matter.
Just the living space, and he's just trying to get another garage under there.
Yeah.
I'm not sure he's keeping both garages, but he's but he's gonna have at least the one garage and then maybe expand the downstairs, so.
Okay.
So, but I'm in favor of it.
Great, thank you for coming out.
Thank you.
Alright. Anyone else? I see none.
I'll make a motion to close the public hearing.
I'll second.
Sorry.
All those in favor of closing hearing?
Aye.
Aye.
Did you draw it on?
Yeah, if you have that hand sketched one, okay, that's fine. You give it to Lynn, we'll reference it.
Excellent.
We'll do a work session a little later on. Thanks, Jamie.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, bye, Mike.
See you, Mike. To all interested inhabitants of the town of Sutton, in accordance with the provisions of Mass General Law, Chapter 48, Section 11, the Zoning Board of Appeals will hold a public hearing at the Sutton Town Hall on March 8th, 2018, at 7:35 PM on the petition of Roland Saborn. The petitioner requests a special permit as it pertains to Section 1C2D of the town zoning bylaws, allowing the tear down and rebuild of a single-family home where both lot and structure are pre-existing, non-conforming in nature. The property that is the subject of this petition is located at 5 Sunrise Drive, as shown on Assessor's Map Number 14, Parcel Number 32. The property is located in the Residential Rural Zoning District. A copy of the petition may be inspected during normal office hours in the town clerk's office, located in the town hall. Any person interested or wishing to be heard in this variance petition should appear at the time and place designated. Daniel Petrelli, Board of Appeals Clerk. Welcome. State your name for the record.
I'm Matthew Sabrin. I'm the owner of the property. And this is the proposal here. I have some photos of the existing house and the new dimensions. In here, the yellow is currently the existing, and that blue would be the new. The existing. The closest point, it's less than a foot away from the property line, and when we rebuild, we think that's going to be an issue. So we're going to move we're proposing to move the house over a little bit.
Sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, and the property has a well and a new approved Title V system, and the design matches the neighborhood.
So the neighboring properties in those two pictures there? Yeah.
Yep, these are the two houses.
That's the two next door ones? Okay.
So I would be the yellow one in there, and those would be the two orange.
All right.
So the properties on either side of it are further from the lake than you are?
One is actually going to be closer. You'll see the existing structure would be here, the lake's up on this side.
Okay.
So this one's actually closer and this one's actually further away. They're kind of staggered on the line.
And 4.2 is the dimension of the new?
Yes.
The new house?
And that would be actually a post to one of the decks over here. And
okay.
That 4.2 would give us access to stain and inspect and
yep.
be able to maintenance those posts.
So this plot plan, it shows it's like a little bump, right?
Yep.
So that exists even though it's like too small for these other ones?
Yes.
Is that how that is?
Yep.
Really creative lot shape.
What's that, the little block?
Yeah, see, there's a little bump there, but you wouldn't see it like over here, for example.
3 feet.
Maybe they built the first house in the wrong spot.
Yeah, I know, right?
That's how they fixed it.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be the first time.
I think you're right.
doing anything with the garage?
No, the garage is up top and no, it's gonna stay the same.
There's a, the existing house is a canopy, is that right? And that's not gonna carry over?
No, that's gonna be removed.
So do you know the existing square footage of the existing house?
I believe it's 616.
616, does that include the canopy?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, no, that does not include the canopy.
Okay. So maybe around 800, including that, roughly?
Yeah, similar. The differences between the percentages are down here. The new proposed is 76 square feet bigger.
So the 1,344 includes the existing garage?
Yes.
Do we have any other questions from the board?
No, sir.
Anyone here would like to speak for or against this petition? I see none. Does anyone feel we need to do a site visit on this?
I don't think so. I think he's done a nice job showing the houses on either side.
Yeah. I agree. Pretty complete set of plans. Adjusting the house to make it a little less non-conforming?
The house is already non-conforming with the wetland buffer. Does it become more non-conforming? I see it like kind of shifts diagonally along with the buffer, it seems like. It seems like it's pretty close, right? Because it's like...
Yeah, I would say it's going to be similar to what it is now.
Yeah.
So the only material difference between the existing structure and the old structure is, with the exception of a slightly larger footprint and a little bit of a different orientation, you increase the roof pitch enough to get some usable space on the second floor?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, the second floor is about 500 square feet of living up there.
How much higher is the ridge?
I think... this proposed is going to be around 30 feet, and right now I think it's just at 20. So I think it's about 10 feet taller.
And they have like a walkout basement?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to kind of model that same basic walkout idea, and that's kind of the contour of the property anyways.
Yep.
All right. How's it? Everyone's good without a site visit? I think I am.
I think so.
Yeah.
What's across the street? They have a similar lot layout.
When you say across the street, do you mean on this opposite side of Sunrise Drive, or?
Yes.
That's all unused land.
Okay, so no houses right there. You'd be blocking their view or anything like that. Okay.
No, there's no one on that side.
Okay. Okay. No, sir. I don't have any questions.
I will entertain a motion to close this hearing.
Make a motion to close this hearing.
Second on that?
I'll second that.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, we'll do a work session in a couple minutes, and Lynn will let you know.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next on our agenda, we had continuance for the TJJ development project on 182 Manchog Road. And we received this letter. Dear members, on behalf of the applicant, TJJ Development Corp., please accept this letter as a formal request to continue the public hearing for the above referenced project to the next regular scheduled public hearing of the Sutton Zoning Board of Appeals. As an update, the applicant has retained a new architect for services and is developing floor and elevation plans for the building. These will be submitted to the board for their review upon their completion. We hope this serves your needs at this time. Should you have any questions or require additional information, please contact this office. Very truly yours, Andrew Survey and Engineer. So I would entertain a motion to grant their request for a continuance to our next meeting while they continue to work on their plans.
I'll make a motion to, did you ask something, Mike? I was gonna say I'll make a motion, but I just wanted to say, this is the third time this project's been in front of us, and if we didn't challenge to see some blueprints, I think it's good that we're making them make sure what they're coming in front of the board this time is what they truly want. I wouldn't be surprised if we see a change in footprint. You know, well, I mean, when you start to just go by a footprint and not a design, and then you try to design your house, and I think that as a board, when we ask for the things we ask for, it helps the applicant through the process, so to not have to come three times. I know you guys haven't been here for a while, but this is the third time this non-built house is coming in front of the board. And we all do it as volunteer, I don't wanna say they waste our time, but it's good to be thorough and make sure you know what you want, and so I will make, oh, go ahead.
I will motion we grant the approval to continue the 182 Manchot to our next meeting.
April 5th at 7:40.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, we also have some meeting minutes. We had two meetings back in February. Should have been reflected in your paycheck.
Good bonus.
And we also have the December minutes.
Still not getting my checks.
No?
Don't get one yet?
We're looking.
Your check's coming in.
Oh, I see. Some sort of bullying type thing.
Well, his kids are older, he needs the money bill, the kids are still young.
Amazing.
Wait till your kids get into hockey, you'll find out what it's all about.
You'll be taking the checks from Rich.
So I entertain a motion on our December 7th meeting minutes.
I'll make a motion to accept the meetings as written.
Second on that?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Next up, we have our February 1st minutes.
I'll make a motion to accept those minutes as written.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
And then we have our February 8th minutes also.
Why can't we go in order? I'll make a motion to accept
them. We went December, then February, and February 8th, I mean, what order would you like?
Oh, I thought they were in order. Didn't you just say December?
No.
Oh, February 8th. I'll make a motion to accept the February 8th minutes as written.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, I'll entertain a motion to open a work session on a petition of Joseph Charlie.
Here's the plan.
I just want to make a motion to open a work session on 37 Maple Lane.
I'll second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion on this petition. He's seeking a special permit. Yep.
With it.
garage one room, that was easy to understand, the footprint, the height.
Yeah, I guess the only thing is we just make sure the elevation, yeah. They wouldn't do anything different, I mean, it's just one of those.
Is he gonna?
A garage with a one-story addition above it is how we could word it.
Is he gonna put the floor plan in there too? I didn't see that.
Sounds like this.
Probably, I think it's just an open room.
It's an open room, it's like.
Usually we're doing a whole house, like, this is really simple, it's a small little addition, I mean, I know we usually like to see floor plans, but it's one room, in one garage, yeah.
It's just one room, yeah.
So I'll make a motion to approve the application for 37, is it 37? 37 Maple Lane, Joe Shirelli. Based on the appropriateness of the specific site as a location for use, the adequacy of public sewage and water system exists, the effect of the developed use upon the neighborhood, almost none. Undue nuisance, serious hazard, vehicles or pedestrians, and whether they're appropriate facilities or proper operation, yeah. So I'll make a motion to approve the special permit application request for 37 Maple Lane. And then the motion should include the condition that the height will be, the height of the ridge will be no higher than the existing structure.
Yep.
And that the driveway not be expanded at the width at the road.
Okay.
But only at the building. And on, and it would include, as depicted in the drawing and the sketch, a 6-foot landing and stairway to go parallel with the back of the house and not directly out from the house, but parallel with the house.
Have you seen
six
the,
by
did
eight.
You see the sketch? He drew 6 by 8.
Oh, six
by eight?
Eight?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Was it 8 or 8?
Check my eyes. 6 by 8, I think, right?
Six by eight,
land, like a landing.
Landing, yeah. Oh,
six
yeah,
by
deck,
eight
so
landing.
So it'll be six feet from the building, though.
Right.
Yeah.
8 foot, 8 feet long.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. So 6 feet out would
yeah.
be the encroachment.
6 feet out, yeah, would be what we're worried about.
Okay. So were there too many words in that?
No.
Okay.
We don't have to write.
Is this town sewer over this end of town?
No, he said there's a septic on the other end.
And did he address, like,
the septic? The septic's on the other side of the
yeah,
house, that's why I couldn't do anything.
Kind of constraining
okay.
where you can put it, yeah.
Yep, perfect.
All right, any other discussion? We had a motion?
That was the motion.
We had a second?
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? The ayes have it.
So I got a reference to this specific one.
Right, and then also, I don't know if you want to label this sketch as sketch A or
sketch A.
Sketchy.
Sketch A and sketch B. All right, I could entertain a motion to open a work session.
Do we need to close that or anything? Are we done?
We done. We
do
voted
we?
On it.
And that's the end of it. All right. That's why you do this part.
I haven't gotten a lot of sleep lately, so I could be wrong, so
nope.
keep an eye on
that's
it.
All right.
All right, I entertain a motion to open a work session on the petition of Roland Saborn. He also is seeking a special permit to tear down and rebuild his pre-existing non-conforming house.
I'll make a motion.
Second on that?
Second.
When I'm referencing this one, should I just put that number for the site plan? What is this number? I know, it's like, I don't want to write all this.
Yeah. Yeah, you can, that's probably the plan number, or yeah, I would say so.
Sorry.
You could also mention
the stamp date on that one.
Okay, yeah, yeah, I got that.
Okay, great.
Cool.
So we got a motion and a second. All those in favor of opening a work session?
Right.
Aye. I'll entertain a motion. Someone
okay.
sees fit.
I will make a motion based on the presentation to approve the special permit for 5 Sunrise Drive to replace the existing home at that address based on our special permit criteria, A1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't need to read all of those, do I? So that's my motion. I don't think there, we need any conditions because he provided elevation, floor plans, plot plans. He's moving the house over from the existing side setback sideline. Moving the house over a little bit. It's a little bit larger and Mr. Chairman, you pointed out that, or maybe I was actually, Mr. Virgili pointed out that it kind of slides along that water buffer there. But I don't think it's any more non-conforming than the existing house. Kind of in keeping with the neighborhood, you know, I thought he did a nice job presenting photographs of the houses on either side. I'm familiar with the road, so it, you know, I think it's, you know, it's consistent with the other houses that are there.
I agree.
Not going across the street, it's not going to block anybody's view, so.
A well-prepared application.
Certainly is.
So we have a motion. Do we get a second on that?
I'll second that.
Any other discussion? All those in favor of granting the special permit?
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Ayes get it again. Is that all our business? That was it for the minutes, right, Lynn? Entertain a motion to adjourn?
A motion, we adjourn.
Oh, stop now. That's the best one of the night.
Hi, Mike.
Hi, guys.
Is there a second on that?
Mike, you can second.
I'll second it.
All those in favor?
I'll second some, all my.
Aye. See you in April. Thank you. All right, you have a, okay, you got your plan up.
Yeah.